Thank you, sir. First of all, I would like to say thanks to RDOS and CSOS for giving me opportunity to share my work. And I also respect my seniors and my teachers. Now I am presenting my experience in achieving near zero figure infection. Is it possible? No, zero is not possibility, but near zero is definitely a possibility. And how can we achieve? So I am not going to tell you anything different what my seniors and other other persons have told you, but I am stick to basics. So now we go to back to basics. I will go to next slide. Yeah. Now if you will ask me how much weightage I give to the different in my practice, so first I will say that I will give disinfection and sterilization 50% weightage. That includes OT design, proper OT zoning, autoclave, scrubbing, and autoclave, this irrigating fluid or whatever we are using. Now my second will come the wound closer. I'll give definitely 40% contribution to the to achieve the infection, that is the this thing, and another 10% is for the other various things, that is hand hygiene, betadine solution, systemic antibiotic, post-operative, and all of it. So first of all, we'll cover the 10% first. This thing, 10%. So let's see. So first of all, I am going for the hand hygiene. This is very important of point which has to be considered in every hospital setup. It starts from the OPD, and actually if you will see, like I am using free sterilium, or it's not no financial interest, but I am using sterilium for all the staffs, including from the reception, optometrist, nursing station, investigation, procedure room, and including my concentration chamber. If I count, I have only four chambers, four rooms is there. So, but still my use is approximately 1.5 liter per month sterilium only in my OPD. So that is definitely going to reduce your prior burden to infection. Now we'll go to the next step, that is the pre-op room preparation. So here I use 5% betadine solution at least 2 to 3 times in alternation with any antibiotic, moxifloxacin 0.3%, gatifloxacin 0.5% eye drop every 5 minutes for minimum three times. It achieves MIC level in the anterior chamber fluid, and also it disinfects the conjunctival cul-de-sac. And I am not giving any oral antibiotics preoperatively. Although it may prolong little bit of time for the patient, but definitely it makes you sure the disinfection rate. Now I am going for the most important, that is the disinfection and sterilization. 50% this thing is there. So here I am first starting from the OT design. This proper zoning of the OT is very important. You have to maintain anyway three zone partition level to reduce the infection rate. So this is the brief. My OT structure is there. Here, if you'll start from the first. If we'll start from the first this thing, that is the zone area, that is the receiving area, that down arrow is there. From there I will go to the change room, and beyond change room there is a one recovery room, and that passage is also there. And from there we enter to the either scrub room, or we'll go to the zone 3, that is the main operation room. And from there we'll come back to the down arrow is there, so that is the exit door. Few big hospitals, they are maintaining even zone 4 also for the taking of the all the disinfected or used materials. Now OT design, this is very important. I don't have any washroom or toilet inside the OT after change room. That is very important, because I have visited few hospitals in the all over India. And there in few hospitals I have noted that they are allowed to go for the toilet or washroom even with the changed this clothes. So this should not be there. This is another contamination. And there should not be any exhaust or glass window in any of the walls of the aseptic zone. That is the main operation theater. Now NABH also says that there should not be any glass or any this wooden particle, any partition should be there. And I am using UV treated water for scrubbing of staff as well as myself also. And inside the OT, I don't have any source of water that is giving the untreated water. Now, we are maintaining normal OT protocol as already madam has told about the protocols, gowning and other thing. One important point I just wanted to make sure, Saxena sir has also shown in this thing in his video, that before taking the gown for the staff as well as surgeon, definitely use the sterile gown. And suppose if we are operating CAM cases, then we change gown after every 3 cases. And set to be changed after every case. Now we'll come to the OT maintenance. Fumigation I have already stopped long back. I am doing fogging with the quaternary ammonium chloride or bacillus. This is 5% return, but actually we are using 1% solution, 0.5% for the mopping. Floor mop. This is also somewhere it's wrongly written. That is, we are using bacillus extra solution that is used usually for the pharma industries where they are producing the injections and other drops. Sterilium for hand cleaning, and we do also check all the our equipments like autoclave, their rubber, coil, drum closer, that should be proper. Now, one sterilization, OT drums and linen, here I am using, that is not immediate IUSS. This is the term immediate use steam sterilization. IUSS term came actually in the 2014-15 by the AO, ASCRS and their joint meeting. Here what they are saying that in case of they are using freshly autoclaved instrument and linen which assures your sterilization and safety rather than using old sets. I am not using any old autoclaved set, although it increases my this stay time, and but it makes me sure that instruments are properly sterilized. So what is the actually IUSS? IUSS is the process for steam sterilizing an instrument that is needed immediately. This is not intended to be stored for the later use and which allows for the minimal or no drying after the sterilization cycle. There are definitely concerns about the IUSS for the widespread use. They are in typical IUSS, they were not giving time for the pre-cleaning, but here I am giving the pre-cleaning of the instrument also, like I am using it like a routine sterilization. In IUSS, they were also having concern regarding the inadvertent contamination during transfer of the sterile material. But there is another paper which is saying that if your transfer time is less than 3 minutes, it can be definitely used. There another concern was damage to the instrument. But here we are using proper wrapping of the instrument, which increases the durability of the instrument. And it is very surprising that my annual cost of replacement of the instrument is less than 2,000 per year. I'm not including FACO probes and tips. Concentration, another concern is wet instruments. If you are doing proper wrapping of the instrument, that wet instruments can also, that wetting of the instrument can also be reduced. The only main concern is the potential for burns, which we can reduce with the proper staff instruction. Now, for sterilization operating fluid, I am using definitely glass bottle RL, which I do autoclave. I am not using any plastic bottles or pouches or anything. And even for syringe also, before opening, I am checking for the leakage of the air. And I am also not using no intracameral injection, although this is controversial. Now we'll come to the wound closer. There is no alternative for the wound closer. Definitely you have to do tight closer, perfect closer. Everything you have to do, no hesitation for the putting the sutures. You are, suppose if any complication is there, vitreous loss or anything, definitely you make sure that you are closing the wound with full integrity. And routine, I am using 1% antibiotic plus one drop of antibiotic and steroid. Post-operative care, this is one another thing I am doing. I am keeping my patient in post-operative room. There, my 99% surgery is under topical, so I don't do any patch or anything. So in my post-operative care room, I am putting the antibiotic steroid drops frequently, at least 2 to 3 times. And before discharging, I am checking on the slit lamp on the same day and give oral antibiotics for the 3 days. And rest other management is same. This is also very important. Before discharging, I give routine instruction as well as I explain to the patient that alarming symptoms. What are the alarming symptoms? In case that you have to report very early rather than waiting for the next follow-up. Sometimes I use a WhatsApp image also from the patient, although I don't give any advice on the WhatsApp or mobile, this thing. But definitely I can, I use WhatsApp image to get the patient's problem or suppose if any image. And one another important point is moral responsibility about sterility. First of all, we have to sensitize our staff regarding the sterilization. If our staff is knowing what is the harmful effect of the not maintaining the sterilization, they will definitely give proper attention and encourage them to say the truth if any mistake happens. And if you are not satisfied with the your protocols, what you are following, it is definitely better to delay or postpone the OT rather than going with the compromised situation.
Mahesh, can you sum up? You have short of time.
The last and but real truth yet to disclose is pray to the God, because blessings of the God is the most powerful measure. Thank you. This is my wonderful staff. And at the outset, I would like to invite all of you to the Indore for AIUS 2019. Thank you.
Harsh has come announcement to make.
The best of best free paper session.